Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 15.3.1 to the public. This is available now at the same time everywhere around the world and is available on iPhone 6S, 6S Plus, all the way up to the latest iPhone 13 and 13 Pro Max. Now, if you're not seeing the update, just go to your settings, go to General, then go to Software Update, and you should see the update there. If you're still not seeing it, turn off automatic updates and then check again and you should see it. However, if you're a beta tester and you're on iOS 15.4, you won't see the update right now. Now, this particular update came in at a fairly small 254.9 megabytes. That's on my iPhone 13 Pro, and it was about 200 megabytes on all the other devices you'll see in this video. Now, along with this update, Apple also released iPadOS 15.3.1, WatchOS 8.4.2, which is a bit of a surprise since we had 8.4.1 last week, as well as macOS 12.2.1. All of those are available to the public right now. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to Settings, then we'll go to General, then About. Under Software Version, if you tap on the software version there, you'll see the build number. And the build number just lets us know that we're on the current version. You can see the build number is 19D52. And anytime we have a 15.3 and then 0.1, it typically means we have a bug fix and security update. There was something critical that Apple needed to resolve. And the first thing is there is no modem update on 15.3.1. at least on the 13 Pro. So if you were having issues switching between 5G, 5G UC, 4G LTE, or anything like that, this shouldn't be really any different than the previous update of 15.3 since they haven't updated the modem. However, they have resolved a few issues. Now, the first thing that they've actually resolved and they've mentioned has to do with accessibility. If we go to Settings, then we go to Accessibility. If you're visually impaired, you can use a third-party Braille display. And people were having issues with this where it wouldn't respond sometimes. So if you were using a Braille display with your device, whether you're visually impaired or you needed it to learn Braille, it should now work properly. So that's great to see. They've fixed that bug. And if you were having that, hopefully it's resolved it for you. Earlier today, Apple also released a press release about AirTags and unwanted tracking. There's been quite a bit of concern around this if you have AirTags and maybe they're not just tracking things like backpacks and more. So you'll see as we scroll down, they've been working with law enforcement and it says advancements coming to AirTag and the Find My network, new privacy warnings during AirTag setup, addressing alert issues for AirPods, and updated support documents. So they've been addressing issues around this and there will be changes in the future so that we can have more information if there's an AirTag around us that doesn't belong to us. So we'll see those updates in the near future. As far as other issues they've resolved, well, the one thing they haven't mentioned is the pink screen issue. They've acknowledged that publicly, but the pink screen, what that means is the display would turn pink or purple and then fully reboot. They haven't mentioned whether they've fixed that or not, and they didn't fix it in iOS 15.4 betas yet, so we're waiting to see if they've actually resolved it. However, with the storage bug, it does appear that it's much better now. Now, they haven't mentioned it publicly, but if we go to General, then iPhone Storage, on all the devices, I've tested it here with the 12 Pro and or the 12 Pro Max and the iPhone SE second generation, it seems to load much, much faster and be accurate. So if I go to iPhone Storage, you see it just popped up there, and it took within 5 seconds or less and fully populated with all of the different storage, including system data, which sometimes doesn't show up. So hopefully that's resolved for most people. Most people said it was working for them in 15.3, but there were some issues where it wasn't. Now it seems to be fully working in this update. So it looks like they've resolved it. Hopefully it's resolved for you, but they haven't mentioned it publicly. The other thing they haven't mentioned is the music bug. There's a music bug that they had with 15.3 and earlier versions where if you're streaming music, maybe you're streaming instead of downloading it to your device, it can use excessive CPU cycles and in turn cause the phone to use a lot of battery. I'm not sure if that's resolved yet as they haven't mentioned it, but we'll know after a few days when we see what the battery's like. So that will give us a better insight into that. Now, there is a security update in this update, and you can see that yourself if you go to the Apple Security website, and all you need to do is scroll down. So if you go to the Security website, you'll see the latest versions here with macOS Monterey 12.2.1, watchOS 8.4.2, and iOS and iPadOS 15.3.1. If you scroll down, you'll see there's one fix, and it has to do with WebKit, or what's the underlying code for Safari. And so as you can see, it says impact, processing maliciously crafted web content may lead to arbitrary code execution. Apple is aware of a report that this issue may have been actively exploited. To fix this, A use after free issue was addressed with improved memory management, and then someone let them know anonymously that this was an issue. So they've resolved this, it's a security update, and patched a very critical issue. The same thing has been patched on iPad as well. So all of those things are resolved in this particular update. Now, as far as if you should install iOS 15.3.1, if you're on a previous version of iOS 15, many people said 15.3 was the best version as far as overall performance and everything else. With 0.1, you're getting a security update and a bug fix, so I would highly recommend it. Of course, if you're having an issue with accessibility and the Braille display, definitely install it. However, if you're on the beta, I wouldn't necessarily roll back to this version, as we should have newer betas in a little while. Now, as far as when to expect iOS 15.4 beta 3, we can expect that probably next week, maybe on Tuesday or Wednesday, the 15th or 16th of February, with maybe a beta the following week. So we could be on a 1 to 2 week cycle. We're not sure yet, but if we're on a 1 week cycle, we can expect a beta next week, then another one the following week, with maybe a release candidate in the first week of March, with the final release sometime in the second week of March, where we expect a new Apple event on March 8th. So it looks like that could be the time frame. They haven't announced this publicly, but it does seem very likely. Now, as far as battery life in iOS 15.3.1, well, like I said earlier, it will take a few days to know what that's like, and battery life typically was pretty good for most people on 15.3. Over 70% in the follow-up video that I did said that it was better or the same as previous versions, so it does seem to be doing well for them. As far as what you can expect, I wouldn't expect a change. However, after installing the update, the device will have to do things such as index in the background that will use some power, and it may not be great battery the first day, but it improves over the next day or two. So we'll be checking that out over the next couple of days. Also, the device was quite warm after installing the update. In fact, it's still a little bit warm. I wouldn't really be concerned about that, as it's typically doing a lot of processing and things in the background. So that's typically what's going on after you install an update. If it doesn't ever cool down, maybe do a hard reboot. But the other devices I have here are nice and cool, so I wouldn't worry about heat or anything like that. But the 13 Pro does seem to be processing quite a bit. As far as overall performance, performance is nice and smooth. ProMotion seems to be working well, and I haven't noticed any problems whatsoever. It seems nice and smooth. And as far as on older devices as well, I wouldn't expect it to be much different, since it's just a bug fix and security update. Typically, you're going to see about the exact same performance when it comes to that. And so that's everything in iOS 15.3.1, some bug fixes and security fixes, and not a whole lot more. We expected this, but we expect many more features with 15.4, and later on at WWDC 2022, which should be around June, where we see iOS 16. So typically that's where we'll see a ton of new features or maybe visual changes as well. But if you found anything else in this particular update, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.